required where farmers are exposed to hazards such as toxic or corrosive chemicals, biological pathogens, thermal extremes, etc. So using protective clothing while working with the pesticide helps to reduce the risk of exposure to pesticide and pesticide poisoning. Studies show that over 90% of the chemical exposure occurs through the skin. So here the agricultural activities are being performed without the use of protective clothing, and it is very much evident in the figure that the person is working with the pesticides, the chemicals barefoot and barehanded, and it is leading to the contamination of the ground as well. So to reduce the pesticide exposure, different products using textile and non-biodegradable waste can be used. So looking into the problems of the farm workers, protective clothing material was prepared from textile waste and non-biodegradable waste, as the preference of these protective products was assessed. Then the cost effectiveness of the same was also studied. This study was conducted in Kato village, from where 15 males and 15 females were taken who were indulged in seed treatment, mixing of pesticides and spraying of pesticides. The protective products prepared included mat, mask, hood, apron and gloves, and these were prepared by sandwiching non-degradable waste between the two layers of fabric. So how this is cost effective? The waste garments like the suits, dupattas, the bed sheets, they can be used to develop usable waterproof garments. Like these garments will be very cost effective with the use of second-hand clothes in production of the newer garments. And further, these products can be prepared and sold off at the local markets by the rural women just to overcome the financial problems. So presently, mixing of pesticide, preparation of solution of pesticides, seed treatment is done by keeping the pesticide sprayer and other associated equipment in the ground, which is leading to the ground contamination.
Mat and hood.
then price of the homemade products was compared to those of the market products, and it was found that there was a saving of 86% in case of mat, 40% in case of mask, 85% in case of apron, 33% in case of gloves, and 72% in case of hood. Well, these were developed at home by using the waste textiles and polythene. So to conclude, non-biodegradable waste being waterproof, it acts as a barrier. Thus, it will tend to save the agricultural workers from various health hazards. These protective products can be used while seed treatment, mixing, spraying of different pesticides. Gloves were the most preferred product. It was observed that these products, if developed at home, can help to save the money. And further, it can help in capacity building of the rural. Thanks.
Thank you, Gandhi, for highlighting one of the interesting.